Monday night, the Astros came out swinging as they put up 12 runs on 16 hits. But last night, Greg Maddux was masterful, holding them to just one run. Tonight, Carlos Zambrano takes the hill and hopes to shut them down in the rubber game. Next. Coming to you from Minute Maid Park in Houston, Texas, as Comcast Sportsnet presents Chicago Cubs baseball. And tonight, the all-important rubber game as the Cubs try to pull to within 5.5 of the Houston Astros. It's game 3 of this series. And great to have you with us, Bob Brenly and Len Casper with you tonight. 4-1 the final as the Cubs took Game 2 last night, and this is kind of a two-game swing situation. If the Cubs win, they're within 5.5 of Houston. The Astros, by the way, trying to hold off Washington and the Phillies and some other teams as well. We'll get into the standings a little bit later on, but let's talk about Aramis Ramirez. Overall, you talk about offense and defense. He might have had his best game of the year last night.
I don't think there's any question he had his best game of the year. He was moving well defensively, ran the base as well, obviously swung the bat extremely well. You see his career numbers against the Astros. Even more importantly, in his last 32 ball games, he's hitting .328 with 11 homers and 31 RBIs. He's getting hot at exactly the right time of the season.
And with 22 home runs, by far the most he has hit against any other team. Great pitching matchup tonight. We'll start with Carlos Zambrano over his last 9 starts, an ERA of just over 1.5.
Yeah, well, there's some concern about the back problems. He came back and pitched 6 strong innings, a shutout ball against the Cardinals his last time out. 5-1 over his last 9 starts. The Cubs need a big outing from Carlos tonight.
And Roy Oswalt will pitch for the Astros. He's had a great year, but he has not won over his last 3 starts.
Yeah, in those 20 innings over his last 3 starts, he surrendered 28 base hits and 11 earned runs, so perhaps catching Oswalt at the right time as well.
Carlos, by the way, suffering from some flu-like symptoms, but he's ready to go tonight. Hopefully that won't bother him. The back won't be an issue as well. And we're set for a big game tonight. It's Game 3, the Cubs and the Astros. And again, Zambrano pitching well. He shut out the Cardinals for 6 innings his last time out. We'll have baseball next. Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by Chevy. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today. Walgreens, the pharmacy of the Chicago Cubs. Your Chicago area Lexus dealer who invites you to test drive a Lexus today. Aflac, ask about it at work. Toyota, visit your local Toyota dealer. Toyota, now that's moving you forward. Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, shining through. Land Rover. Visit LandRoverIllinois.com for your Chicagoland retailer. Midas. Trust the Midas touch. Corona. Miles away from the ordinary. And by Southwest Airlines. Nonstop service to over 59 destinations. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
Nice.
Very nice.
Do you think they're...
Oh, yeah. They're plastic. And they're spectacular.
Just in time for summer, it's the Coors Light Cooler Box. 18 16-ounce plastic bottles that stay colder longer. Just ice it up, take it out, and enjoy. The Coors Light Cooler Box.
Wow. Close up, they look even bigger.
Chevy's proud to have the best-selling full-size SUVs 5 years in a row. Like Tahoe with best-in-class fuel economy. We've always broken the rules. Now we're rewriting them. With the Chevy employee discount for everyone. You pay what we pay, not a cent more. Now get an 05 Chevy Trailblazer LS two-wheel drive with an MSRP of $27,154. Chevy employee discount price of $21,417 after cash back. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today.
At Geico.com, you can handle all your car insurance needs online. It's so easy, a caveman could do it.
Seriously, we apologize. We had no idea you guys were still around.
Yeah, next time maybe do a little research.
Gentlemen, are we ready to order?
I'll have the roast duck with the mango salsa.
I don't have much of an appetite, thank you.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Welcome back to Minute Maid Park. Again, the roof is closed tonight. And we're getting set for game three of this series. The Astros winning Monday night. The Cubs came back. An efficient 4-1 win as Greg Maddux defeated Andy Pettit. So the season series is knotted up at four apiece through the first eight. Talked about the Astros leading the wild card. Some things could change tonight as you see the numbers for Maddux last night. He was terrific through just 70 pitches in his seven innings. Kerry Wood and Ryan Dempster closed it out. Washington is playing at Philadelphia tonight. They were postponed last night. So while the Cubs can get to within 5.5 of Houston, if the Nationals win tonight and the Astros lose, Frank Robinson's club would be leading the wild card. So right now the Cubs are six back of Washington. We were talking about all the math off the air. And as you said, just got to worry about yourself right now. Just win.
Just win ball games right now. That Washington-Philadelphia game, Esteban Loaiza against John Lieber in that matchup, that should be a good one. We should have a good one here tonight as well. Roy Oswalt, as we mentioned, has not been at the top of his game recently, but one of the best right-handers in Major League Baseball. And, of course, we know what Carlos Zambrano is capable of doing on a given night.
So Oswalt getting ready. Carlos Zambrano and Michael Barrett heading from the bullpen toward the Cub dugout. Boy, if Houston loses and the Phillies win, you'd have three teams all within a half game in the wild card. And it should be a great race right to the finish. Cubs will play the Astros seven times in their final nine games to end the regular season. Let's take a look at the Cubs Southwest starting lineup. The Cubs have won four of their last six. Lawton, Walker, and Lee at the top. Ramirez with that great game last night. Garcia Parra at short. Corey Patterson batting sixth. Jeremy Burnett has struggled lately, so he's down to seventh in the order. And Barrett and Zambrano round it out.
Take a look at the Astros defensively. Lance Berkman moving out to left field for the start tonight. Willie Taveras in center. Orlando Palmeiro in right field. Ensberg at third, Everett at short, Biggio at second, Mike Lamb getting a start at first base tonight. Brad Ausmus, the veteran high-end catcher behind the plate for right-hander Roy Oswalt. You see his numbers on the season. Sparkling ERA of 2.57. Needless to say, there's a little bit of history between Roy Oswalt and the Chicago Cubs, and I'm sure the Cubs would like nothing better than to drop an L on him and get out of town.
Well, he has lost once at home this year. It was on opening day against St. Louis, so he's won 10 consecutive decisions here at home. And it'll be Matt Lawton to lead it off. 0 for 5, 3 strikeouts last night. So a rough night for him, even though the Cubs did win 4-1. And Oswalt ready. The first pitch is a fastball that misses. Ball one, and we're underway. Crew chief Randy Marsh is back at the plate, and a single smack to center by Matt Lawton to start it. So a good beginning.
We know the Cubs don't run a lot. Matt Lawton figures to be one of the guys in this lineup tonight, along with Corey Patterson, that may attempt to steal a base. Oswalt fairly quick to home plate, but Brad Ausmus behind the plate has really had some problems this year. Only 7 out of 40 throwing out base runners. That's 18% caught stealing.
Todd Walker way out in front. A very slow curveball from Roy Oswalt. The Cubs with 4 steals over the last 5 games. They had 1 in the previous 15. Kick and the pitch. Outside corner for a strike. Oswalt likes to work quickly. He's about the same size as Greg Maddux. 6 feet, 185. Off the glove of Biggio into right. Lawton is going to hit toward third. Palmeiro will just lob it to Everett at second. First and third with nobody out.
Good start to this game by the Cubs offensively. Gary Oswald would have to be considered one of the best pitchers in the National League. And like most good pitchers, if you give him an opportunity to get comfortable out there on the mound and find his release point, he can be extremely tough. So putting a lot of pressure on him early here.
Now Derek Lee, 8 for 27 in his career with two home runs against the Astros right-hander. One strike. Oswald has not won over his last three starts, so still trying to get his 15th win. Slow bouncer, and Lawton's going to hold. The throw will go over to first. As Ensberg throws out Lee, second and third, one out.
Looked like there was some indecision on the part of Matt Lawton down there at third base. Slow roller hit down that third base line. The biggest question is the ball hit hard enough to turn a double play? If it's hit hard enough to turn a double play, then you have to break for home plate. But that ball was slowly hit, allowing Walker to advance to second base. The only out the Astros could get was at first.
What a night for Ramirez last night. 3 for 4, two doubles, and a home run. Of course, you would think that you'd be a little bit more conservative with nobody out, right? With one out, probably going a little bit more on contact. And the hope here is that Aramis can get the job done. But now he's in an 0-2 hole. Carlos Zambrano will look for his 10th win tonight. Greg Maddux got win number 10 last night.
Boy, Maddux was spectacular last night. Vintage Greg Maddux, just pounding the corners, changing speeds. Astros hitters just didn't get many good swings on the Mad Dog last night. I thought it was interesting some of his comments about being mentally fatigued pitching against Andy Pettitte, because you know you have to be at your best. You know you have very little margin for error against a guy who had been pitching as well as Andy Pettitte had been pitching. So Mad Dog said he wasn't so much physically tired, he was mentally exhausted in that ball game last night.
Well, Andy Pettitte pitched well, 7 innings, 3 runs, but Maddux was better. Inside on Ramirez, 2-2.
I've said it every time we've had him behind the plate. I'll say it once again. Randy Marsh, one of the best umpires in baseball. However, he is not prone to call strike three on hitters. Borderline pitches are usually going to go in favor of the batter. He'll call strike one. He'll call strike two. But you have to get that ball over the white part of the plate to get a called strike three.
2-2 on Ramirez. Second and third. One out. Here's a pitch in the air to center, medium depth. This should be able to score Lawton. Here comes Matt toward the plate. The throw by Taveras. He is late. A sack fly for Ramirez. And he is now tied Derek Lee for the team lead in RBIs, each with 89. So it's 1-0.
You know, Aramis would have liked to have done more damage with this swing, but he got that fly ball deep enough into center field to score Matt Lott from third, get the Cubs on the board first. That is huge in the rubber game of the series here. Get on the board, make the Astros play catch up.
Strike one, Nomar Garciaparra, 1 for 3 with a walk and a run last night. He's hit an 8 of his last 9 at a 382 clip. This one foul and out of play. Nomar has long been known as a guy who doesn't look at a lot of video. He's more of a see the ball and hit the ball type of guy. And I asked him today about that. He said, yeah, if I watch any video, it will be of my swing. But he said, I don't watch a whole lot. And everybody's different. And for a career 320 hitter, It certainly works just fine for him.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. I mean, personally, I think there's something to be gained by watching videotape of the opposing pitcher that night. But for some hitters, they just feel it gives them too much to think about. They're much better off just getting in the batter's box and reacting to what they see. There's a borderline pitch that Oswald does not get on a two-strike count. Osmus had slid out on that outside corner. That pitch is off the plate away, but the strike zone that Greg Maddux was pitching to last night, that would have been strike three.
Couple of hits and a sac fly. And then it's 1-0 Cubs. John Walker still out there at second. And the pitch swung on and missed as Oswalt picks up his first strikeout. The Cubs get one. Zambrano to the mound when we come back to Houston.
Before I forget, here are your bills.
Bills?
For what? Calling me on my cell phone.
$8.50.
Did I ask to hear about your lady problems?
$23?
Trust me, the only one who wants to hear about your golf game is you.
He's got a point.
What?
Why pay for calls you didn't make? Switch to U.S. Cellular.
Now get unlimited call me minutes plus 400 anytime minutes for just $24.95 a month. U.S. Cellular. We connect with you.
It's here, Suzuki Smart Summer Savings, where more and more people are discovering Firenza.
Firenza! Firenza! By Suzuki!
Firenza's got it all. Style, function, and America's number one warranty.
And it comes with more room.
And more features than Civic.
Who says you can't have it all?
Suzuki is on a roll with great cars, great deals, and America's number one warranty. So don't miss Suzuki's Smart Summer Savings.
It was the smartest move I ever made.
Firenza!
Get the Firenza for just $11,994 during Suzuki's Smart Summer Savings.
Wait for the bear season, then get your football picks this summer with Comcast Sportsnet's Countdown to Kickoff. Our news crew is all over the Bears training camp in Bourbon A to bring you the latest news. Plus, hear from the players and coaches on how they're preparing for the upcoming season and get up close and personal with your favorite gridiron stars. Don't miss the Countdown to Kickoff every night throughout Bears training camp, only on Comcast Sportsnet.
Really worthwhile.
Animals also possess several.
Burnett's deep to center field. This ball is way back out of here. Jeremy Burnett with a home run.
Oh, yeah.
Are you fan enough? Nobody does baseball better than Comcast Sportsnet. Catch the Cubs all season long. More games, more news, more passion.
You're watching Chevy Baseball Wednesday on Comcast Sportsnet.
Cubs got a run in the top of the inning. Now Phil Garner's Astros lineup. They come in at 64-55, 9 over 500. Tavares, Biggio, and Berkman. Ensberg, Lamb, and Palmeiro in the middle. Adam Everett, the shortstop. Brad Ausmus, Roy Oswalt, the battery. Zambrano with a first pitch strike. On Willie Tavares, who's 6-for-10 with 3 runs in the series. And again, Zambrano looking for win number 10. 0-1 pitch, fouled back to the screen.
It was kind of a waiting game with Carlos to see what he has working on a given night. We know on some nights he just relies on that heavy, hard sinker. Other nights he goes more to that big, flat, sweeping slider. Trying to get his feet underneath him out there on the mound here in the first inning. Get out of this inning with no damage.
He's 3-1 with a 4.85 ERA here at Minute Maid. 4-4 overall against the Astros with a 3.26 earned run average. His first start this year against Houston, and he strikes out Tavares to start it. Tavares last night tripled and scored the only Houston run.
Take a look at the Cubs defensively, brought to you by Rico, Lawton, Patterson, Burnett's the outfield for the Cubs tonight. Ramirez, Garciaparra, Walker, and Lee across the infield. Michael Barrett behind the plate once again for Carlos Zambrano.
Tavares and Biggio have been tons better at home than on the road this year. High fly to right. Easy play for Burnett's, who makes a catch. Tavares hitting 365 at home, under 240 on the road. Craig Biggio over 300, with 16 of his 17 home runs coming in this ballpark.
Well, any home runs Biggio hits are going to be to straightaway left field, down the line in left. He doesn't have the kind of power to drive the ball out of the ballpark to center or the opposite way, so no surprise that all but one of his home runs have come in this ballpark.
Strike one on Lance Berkman. And inside, 1-1. Phillies have drawn first blood against the Nationals at Citizens Bank Park, 2-0. After one, little tapper foul. They were postponed last night. Remember, they got underway and only four outs were recorded before that game was eventually called. Wind and the 1-2 pitch. 2-2. Some sun coming through the glass panels out in left field.
Skies looked very threatening. I'm not sure what direction it would be, but behind us, so behind home plate here at the ballpark, but obviously not a factor. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. Put the lid closed tonight.
And Berkman strikes out, a 1-2-3 opening inning for Zambrano, including two strikeouts. 1-0 Cubs.
Since we introduced the Ford Family Plan, hundreds of thousands of Americans have joined in on the savings. Now we're extending the plan for a limited time. Get the same low prices Ford employees pay for America's most popular line of vehicles. Family pricing on the 5-star crash safety rated Ford Freestyle and 500. Now get an all-new Ford 500 for just $19,995. That's over $2,800 in savings on an all-new Ford 500. No hassles, no gimmicks. Visit your local Ford store today.
Shrimp for $12.99. Scampi seared. Coconut crusted. Flame grilled. Golden fried. 40 shrimp for only $12.99. Joe's new platter is bigger and better than ever. Only Joe's Crab Shack does 40 shrimp for $12.99. It's shrimply irresistible. That's right, 40 scrumptious shrimp for only $12.99. Gotta go eat at Joe's.
Absolutely. We have free checking with direct deposit, so you can pay your bills and get your money however you want, without paying us.
Even if I get cash from a Bank of America ATM 100 times a month?
That would be free.
Even when I pay my bills online?
It's free. You can pay almost any bill.
If I had 65 bills...
As many as you want.
Oh, and if somebody uses my debit card, if it gets stolen or something...
You're covered.
Free checking plus, plus, plus.
Okay. All right, let's do it.
From Bank of America, higher standards.
Looking to purchase tickets for some of the best seats at Wrigley Field? Then check out Replay, the official secondary ticket marketplace on Cubs.com. Replay features some of the best seats to upcoming games being resold by authorized ticket holders. Look for the Replay logo on Cubs.com. It is Corey Patterson leading off the second inning. Cubs got one in the first against Roy Oswalt, who is 1-0 this year and 8-5 in his career against the Cubs. He beat the Cubs on May 1st, but he had to leave in the sixth inning with a sprained right foot. Inside corner for a strike. 1-2. Oswalt, an all-star this year, won the online voting for the final spot on the National League roster. First time as an all-star. Well, he is wasting no time. And that is just foul.
Oswald showcasing that mid to upper 90s fastball here earlier in the ball game. Threw a couple of sliders to Nomar, but basically he's going to stick fastball, curveball. There's that fastball I was talking about in the mid to upper 90s. He'll change speeds on his curveball, throwing anywhere from 65 to 75 miles an hour, and we know he's not afraid to pitch inside aggressively.
Swing and a miss. And Patterson out, two strikeouts for Oswald.
Change up a little bit of a split-fingered fastball just off of the outside corner. More often than not, he's going to throw a four-seam fastball. That's the one that gets up there in the high 90s. Occasionally, he'll two-seam it, try to sink it away from a left-handed hitter, but there's the big curveball. Haven't seen that pitch yet in this game.
Well, Burnett's was hitting cleanup 2 weeks ago, but over his last 13 games, 7 for 49. And Jeremy, even against a right-hander, down in the order, batting seventh. 0-2, he's outside. Jeremy went to high school in the Houston area. Born in Southern California. Family moved to Texas when he was a youngster. He attended Oklahoma State. Strikes out. Back-to-back K's here to start the second. And it'll bring up Michael Barrett, the catcher.
Well, protecting the plate with two strikes, Bernie chases a two-seamer just off the outside corner. Yeah, most guys will tell you, when they get into a little bit of a slump at the plate, they're chasing bad pitches and missing the good pitches. You get a fastball down the middle of the plate and foul it straight back. And that's kind of been the case with Jeremy over the last couple of weeks. The good pitches he's had to hit, he's unfortunately fouled off or swung through and gets himself in a hole where he has to really battle and swing at pitcher's pitches.
One strike pitch. Now nothing in two on Barrett. Michael has his fingers taped. See the white tape? And that's the hand he uses to give the pitcher the signals. I asked him, do you only do it at night? He said, no, I pretty much do it every game, no matter what the lighting is. He said, it's kind of his comfort zone now.
You know, some catchers will use white out or white fingernail polish on their right hand for night games when there are a lot of shadows around home plate. The pitcher sometimes has trouble seeing the fingers. But Michael goes with the white tape wrapped around the fingers.
So what he used to do is take the chalk from the batter's box and rub it on the back of his hands. He said a lot of places only now just kind of paint the lines. And that's one of the reasons why I went with the tape. Just got a piece of it.
Now that's more problematic than you might expect at the major league level. There are a lot of pitchers on every staff that have problems seeing the fingers, especially, as I said, night games when there are a lot of shadows around home plate. Sometimes you have to go to more visible types of signs. You hang the fingers down between your legs like a catcher normally would do, and then if I touch my chest protector, it's a fastball. If I touch my shin guard, it's a curveball. If I touch my mask, it's a changeup.
Hard on the ground, but right at Adam Everett. And he throws out Barrett. And it's a 1-2-3 second for Oswald. 1-0 Cubs.
Get the bottom line now during Nissan's model year-end clearance. The bottom line on America's most exciting full line, including Nissan Xterra, Titan, and Z. Plus a $199 a month lease for 24 months on the stylish and powerful Nissan Altima. See your Nissan dealer now. Clearance time happens once a year. And that's the bottom line.
Spell simplicity.
Simplicity. F-E-L-D-C-O. Simplicity.
Close enough.
Call 866-4-F-E-L-D-C-O.
Replacing your old windows, siding, and doors is simple. Just call Feldco for top quality at a low factory direct price. Installed by polite, hard-working professionals.
Simplicity.
Feldco.
For quality windows, siding, and doors, call 866-4-FELDCO.
It's a wonderful world. I'm just walking on air. Talk of heaven on earth, I've got more than my share. Haven't got a care. Happy all day through.
Rico Dependability moves your ideas forward.
Wonderful world.
Vacations, too.
Wonderful you.
There are thousands of faces at Robert Morris College, and behind each one of them is a dream. Do you see yourself? Choose your passion, and you can graduate in 3 years or less. There are hundreds of opportunities behind our doors, one for every dream. Your dream. Accessible, affordable, attainable. Robert Morris College. Real college for the real world.
Get complete sports coverage every night on Jim Beam Sports Night. Coming up tonight after Cubs postgame live, the Bears break camp and Terrell Owens returns to Philly. Join Carrie and Chuck for Jim Beam Sports Night tonight after Cubs postgame live only on Comcast Sportsnet. Morgan Ensberg will lead it off for Houston, bottom two. Zambrano went 1-2-3 in the first inning. Ensberg went 4-for-4 Monday, 0-for-4 last night. Having a great year, but he did not get off to a good start. Ensberg hit 246 with just two home runs in April. And he struck out 21 times in 69 at-bats. But then he really got it going.
A lot of supporters here in Houston feel that the Astros find their way into the postseason, and Ensberg should get some serious consideration for MVP. It's hard to argue with that, given the fact that they've been missing some pieces in their offense. Jeff Bagwell on the disabled list right now. Ensberg got off to the slow start, but has basically been carrying this club offensively lately.
2-2 is on the way. A check swing. Yep, he went. Jim Wolf with the call, so Ensberg is out.
You know, Brad Osmus in his 12th full season in the major leagues. He's one of those crafty veteran catchers. Watch him shake his head to Roy Oswalt. Wants Oswalt to shake his head no. And all that does is plant a little bit of a seed of doubt in that hitter's mind, especially a veteran hitter who kind of works counts and has an idea of what pitch he wants to look for, and then all of a sudden you see the pitcher out there shaking his head no, and now you're wondering, am I guessing right here? What should I do? A lot of times catchers will do that in obvious counts. 2-0, 3-1, when it's usually a fastball count, but you have the pitcher out there shake his head no, the hitter thinks, well, wait a minute, did he call for a fastball and he shook it off because he wants to throw a breaking ball, or did the catcher call a breaking ball 3-1 but the pitcher wants to go with his fastball?
Called strike three. Zambrano has faced five hitters and he has struck out four.
Working in a real good rhythm too. Carlos getting the ball quickly from Michael Barrett, getting right back up on that mound, just hammering that strike zone.
Orlando Palmeiro with his second straight start. He started and left last night. A liner is snagged by Nomar. Nice catch. And that ends the second inning. Well, they've only hit the ball in play twice in the first two innings. How about this catch? Still 1-0.
Pontiac Grand Prix, built at the highest ranked plant in North and South America. Vibe, the best selling car in its class. Pontiac G6, Strategic Vision's Total Quality Award winner in its first year. And now, get GM employee pricing on almost every 2005 Pontiac left in stock. That means while supplies last, non-GM owners and lessees can get a 2005 Vibe starting at $14,138. You pay what we pay, not a cent more.
Friday, prepare for some offensive fireworks in the Mile High City as the Cubs bring their big bats into a matchup with the Colorado Rockies, followed by Cubs postgame live. Cubs-Rockies, Friday at 4. Get your game on Comcast Sportsnet.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs. Last week, if you just got the scores, you didn't get the whole picture.
The reason why you play this game is because you want to start. If you're planning to be a backup quarterback, then I really don't think you should be playing in the NFL.
I think the main thing is really just get focused on playing baseball and help this team win some games and get the pennant race.
I think people are taking it way too serious. Let's remember, at the end of the day, it's about the fans, the people that pay to come get entertained and get away from their 40, 50-hour work week.
Get your game on Comcast Sportsnet.
Good morning, Mr. Farquhar. How are we today? Let's just take a look, shall we?
Huh?
Oh, it's a big gap. Maybe we could drill a hard one right up the middle.
Hmm?
We're going inside. Bow! Yes! Out of there! It's out of there! Yes! Yes!
Are you fan enough? Nobody does baseball better than Comcast Sportsnet. Catch the Cubs all season long. More games, more news, more passion.
Thank you.
Monday, August 22nd, joining the celebration of Greg Maddux's 300th win. Be one of the first 20,000 fans to receive a scratch and win card. 100 random winners will take home an exclusive, authentic Greg Maddux 300th win. Wilson A2000 limited edition baseball glove. Compliments of Pepsi and the Museum of Science and Industry.
Nicely done. That's a mouthful.
Say that fast five times. Third inning, 1-0 Cubs. Zambrano to deep right. That ball way back. Out of here. A home run for Zambrano. His fourth career homer. His first this year, and it's 2-0. We've talked throughout this series about how difficult it is to hit a home run to right. But not for Zambrano.
Minute Maid Park has the lowest left-handed batter home run percentage of any ballpark in the National League. No problem for Carlos, though. He turned that ball around in a hurry.
Well, the Cubs are hitting home runs again. Second career home run for Zambrano among his four. So half his career home runs have been in this ballpark. 10 home runs for the Cubs now the last seven games. Lawton way out in front. Pulled it on the ground, and Biggio throws him out.
Well, it's nice that Carlos is able to supply some of his own run support in this ballgame. Our Heineken home run replay. The second home run in Carlos's career here at Minute Maid Park. Saying about pitching a shutout and hitting a home run, you can't lose.
When you were talking about going into a Zambrano outing, you always kind of wait a little bit, see what he has. Well, he has pretty electric stuff on the mound, and he's one for one at the plate with a home run. Second Cubs pitcher to hit a home run this year. Greg Maddux has a home run. It's Biggio moving to his left, and he throws out Walker. Todd, by the way, extended his hitting streak to 8 with that first inning single. He's 1-for-2. Here comes Derek Lee. Strike one. 2-0 Cubs. Oh, one pitch. pitch, also a strike, nothing in two. Derek with 13 steals on the year, trailing Corey Patterson by one. Corey with 14. Got him. The last Cub first baseman to lead the team in stolen bases, Dee Fondi, 1956. Zambrano with the leadoff homer here in the third inning, and the Cubs now lead 2-0.
Can't we stay another day?
Sure.
Florida. Easy to get to, hard to leave. Go to southwest.com for Southwest Airlines $59 internet specials from Chicago Midway to Florida, including our new nonstop service to Fort Myers, Naples. Travel by November 17th.
You are now free to move about the country.
It's Hyundai Summer Clearance, so save the dates to save big, like up to $3,000 cash back on select models. Days are flying by to save on the V6 Hyundai Santa Fe, winner of Strategic Vision's Total Value Award. And don't forget, Hyundai's award-winning quality lets us offer America's best warranty. So circle the dates for up to $3,000 cash back. Only at Hyundai. During Hyundai Summer Clearance, get up to $3,000 cash back on models across the lot.
I hear that you guarantee all your work. Is that true?
Yes.
Can you have our van ready in time for the canoe trip this afternoon?
Absolutely.
Are your 3,000 certified mechanics guided by the ideals of the young Voyagers? He's one of us!
Come to the best, Midas, America's leader in brakes. Pads or shoes for $39.95 plus installation. We always provide an estimate for installation and fully explain any additional work. For mechanics known for their work and their word.
Trust the Midas touch.
I saw him last month at the movies.
You saw him? Man, I've never seen him.
Can I get your autograph?
You make that dad stuff look easy.
Hey, Bob, I love your speech about the birds and the bees.
And you're giving Bob Jr. driving lessons,
too. That was scary.
You cook for your kids every morning.
You cook?
I cook.
Involve parents of the real heroes. They give kids the tools to succeed. See how at mvparents.com. Sponsored by Players Inc. and Coors.
You're my daddy, Bob!
Monsters of the Midway are back, and Comcast Sportsnet is all over Bears training camp with a countdown to kickoff. Our news team brings you closer to your team with news, interviews, and more time on the Bears than anyone else. Don't miss it. Countdown to kickoff every night, only on Comcast Sportsnet. 2-0. Bottom three in the Astros order. Breaking ball for a strike. And two quick ones on Adam Everett, who hit his career-high 9th home run in game one of this series. One away. Seven up, seven down for Zambrano.
Yeah, working his way rather easily through this Astros lineup the first time. Look for the Astros to try to slow Carlos down. Maybe even starting right here with Brad Ausmus. Veteran player. When you see a pitcher's got a real good rhythm going out there, sometimes you have to step out of the batter's box, you know, fake like you have something in your eye. On the other hand, if the guy's out there struggling and can't find the strike zone, and when he does, he throws it down the middle of the plate. The guys run up there to home plate, get in the box as quickly as possible. There you see Ausmus calling timeout as Carlos started his delivery.
Two and zero. The veteran catcher Brad Ausmus, more back tightness. The last time out for Zambrano, he did get through six, however, got the win against the Cardinals, did not allow a run. Two starts ago, he went just three innings in New York. Two-one pitch. Good breaking ball for a strike. And it evens the count at two apiece. The pitcher, Oswald, is on deck. Five wins, just one defeat over his last nine starts for Zambrano, and a 1.56 earned run average. He has not allowed more than three earned runs in any of those starts. Trying to reach huge. Double digits in victories for the third straight year. Won 13 2 years ago, 16 last year. 3-2 almost hit Ausmus. It was a breaking ball. It didn't break very much, and the Astros have their first base runner. The Geico direct quote, Brad Ausmus on the wild card odds. You only look at the team right in front of you. You try to catch that team because you can't catch any of the others until you catch the one directly above you. He's talking about, you know, the Astros last year kind of in a similar spot as the Cubs this year. Maybe a little friendly advice, even though I guess you have to read that twice just to make sense of it. But he understood what he was trying to say. Oswalt bunts. And Zambrano throws to Walker covering first. It was kind of like Greg Maddux last night, something to the effect of, I didn't throw that many pitches, but I threw a lot of pitches.
Almost a yogi-ism. The scary thing is, though, we know what they're talking about.
Yeah, this is more about us than them.
Kind of a sign you spent way too much time around the ballpark when jibber-jabber like that starts to make sense.
Runner at second, two outs. And a slow curveball. Ball one. Well, the Royals lost again, 11-5 in Seattle. Kansas City has now dropped 18 straight.
You really have to feel for Buddy Bell, a good baseball man, a real good man, period. Walked into a tough situation there in Kansas City, hoping to catch lightning in a bottle and at least get them back to respectability, but it doesn't appear that's going to happen with the talent they have on that roster.
2-1, Tavares golfs that one into right center. Patterson will catch up to it, inning over. Three in the books from Houston. Big game tonight. Cubs really need it, and they're up 2-0.
You think about the things people do to pursue their passion and how far they can go when they're confident in their equipment. You think about that. Then you build the only SUV with legendary Volvo safety. The Volvo XC90.
Molecules delivers non-stop protection throughout the life of your oil. Not just oil, Pennzoil.
Give your engine what it wants. Find quality Pennzoil products at Advance Auto Parts.
Car company is big enough to deliver the number one selling cars and trucks in Chicagoland. Chevy. It's an American revolution, and we're taking over.
See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers.
Really worthwhile.
Animals also possess several.
Burnett's deep to center field. This ball is way back.
Hello?
Oh, yeah.
Are you fan enough? Nobody does baseball better than Comcast Sportsnet. Catch the Cubs all season long. More games, more news, more passion.
Aflac! Time for our Aflac trivia question. Who is the only fielder to be on the front end of two triple plays in the same game? I'll give you the answer in the bottom of this inning. It's the fourth, 2-0. Cubs with one in the first and another in the third on the Carlos Zambrano leadoff home run. Big swing by Ramirez. He had a sack fly in the first inning. Hit his 30th home run last night, joined Derek Lee in the 30 homer club. Second pair of Cub teammates to have back-to-back 30 home run campaigns. Billy Williams, Ron Santo, the first Cub teammates to record consecutive 30 homer seasons back in the mid-60s.
And his home run in the ballgame last night, just a towering shot off of Andy Pettit. A high cut fastball that stayed out over the plate. We didn't know if that thing was ever going to come down.
And Ramiro strikes out. So Oswalt with his fifth K. And now he'll face Nomar, who struck out to end the first inning. One of the unique features of this park is the hill out in center field that is in play, Tal's Hill. It's out to 436 out in straightaway center. I like it because it's a little bit controversial. You'll talk to some people and they think it's great. Others don't like it at all. Nomar to deep left field, and he has hit his second home run. Both home runs coming since he came off the DL, and it's 3-0.
Well, that's what you do with a hanging breaking ball right there. Oswalt slowed down his arm speed just a little bit to roll that curveball up there, hoping to get Nomar out in front of the pitch, but he waited back, slugged it up into those Crawford boxes in left field. Watch the location of this pitch. That's about letter high up and out over the plate. Our second Heineken home run replay of the game. This one, Nomar's second home run of the season.
Career homer number 184, his last home run. It was off Aaron Harang of the Reds at Wrigley Field on the ninth, a little over a week ago. Patterson came in tonight hitting 276 since coming back from AAA Iowa. Oswalt has now allowed 14 home runs this year, including two tonight. Anyway, getting back to Tal's Hill. I guess one of the concerns is a center fielder could get hurt. Now, we're only going to have a handful of instances where a ball will get hit onto that hill. There's a ground ball to Craig Biggio, who's had to navigate out there as a center fielder, but I like it. It's different. You don't see it everywhere. And you know, you don't want to see anybody get hurt, but it's just something you don't see very often. Your thoughts?
I'm a little more concerned with the injury factor. Right. As you said, there's not a lot of balls hit out there, but you know, we've seen a couple guys make the blooper reel trying to back up that hill or run up that hill. And, you know, if you sign a free agent center fielder to a multi-year, multi-million dollar contract and he blows out his knee on a gimmick in center field, I'd probably be a little bit upset. And obviously you don't want to establish a precedent that becomes ridiculous, and you know, you wouldn't anticipate it, but you know, put some barrels out in right center field too. Speed bump between first and second, let's really make it tough. A windmill between second and third. I mean, I understand the theory behind it, you know, salute to old-time ballparks that used to have things like that. I guess my one main objection is that the flagpole is on the inside of the fence. I think if they put that behind the fence, it would eliminate a lot of the concerns of opposing managers coming in here.
Well, old Tiger Stadium had the flagpole in play. Backhanded by Lamb, he'll flip to Oswalt, and that ends the inning. Nomar with his second home run of the year, and the Cubs now have a 3-0 advantage.
Not too close. What do you think? I got that insurance?
What insurance is that, Yogi? Aflac.
The one you really need to have. If you don't have it, that's why you need it.
Need what?
Aflac. Well, if you get hurt and miss work, it won't hurt to miss work.
Uh-huh.
And they give you cash, which is just as good as money.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Listen up. This is Darren. He's the newest member of the league.
Whoa, hold up. What can he do?
Can he fly?
No, cannot.
Got superhuman strength, though, right?
Come on, man. You gotta be able to do something. Levitate, go through walls, stop.
I can do one thing.
Well, let's see it.
Dang!
You can room with me.
Hey.
Get an inside perspective of your Chicago Cubs year-round with Vine Line, the club's official monthly magazine. Published out of the Cubs' own friendly confines, Vine Line delivers expert team analysis, exclusive player features, outstanding photography, and more. Call 1-800-248-9467 to order today and receive a free gift with your subscription. Rates start at just $24.95. Vine Line subscriptions are also available at Cubs.com.
As the blistering days of summer take their leave, an event comes along so legendary it can't be missed. The Toyota Time Clearance Event. Get 0.9% financing for 36 months or up to $2,500 cash on Tundra. Or 0% financing for up to 48 months or up to $2,000 cash on 4Runner. And be sure to check out Motor Trend's 2005 Truck of the Year, Tacoma. Catch this event now. When it comes to deals like these, everyone wins. That's moving you forward.
Well, let's answer tonight's Aflac trivia question. The only fielder to be on the front end of two triple plays in the same game. He's a current hitting coach and a former Cub, Gary Gaetti. Former big league third baseman. How about that? A part of six triple plays.
Six triple plays defensively. He also hit into a triple play, so actually part of seven.
Houston offense trying to figure out Carlos Zambrano. They have not done that through three without a hit. One base runner, that was Brad Ausmus walk in the third inning. 2-1, and Biggio pulls it down the line, and that is a fair ball. Craig Biggio with a stand-up double. Now three doubles away from becoming the first player in history to reach 2,700 hits, 250 home runs, 600 doubles, 400 steals, 1,600 runs, and 1,000 RBIs. Wow.
Takes advantage of a hanging slider that time from Zambrano. Just stayed up and out over the plate. Hooks it down into that left field corner. Not going to be many triples hit down into that left field corner. That's a very short throw for a left fielder from the corner back to third base. So Biggio content just to hold up at second.
His 597th double. One ball, no strikes. And Lance Berkman. I sent out our best wishes, get well wishes to Cubs special assistant Gary Hughes. Had hip replacement surgery a couple of days ago, so he's recovering. So Gary, hang in there, and we hope to see you back on the road soon.
Well, I'm sure we will. Gary can't stay away from the ballpark very long.
You mentioned the doubles for Biggio. It was also his 900th career extra base hit. Hit foul to the left. 3-2. Also wanted to mention, if you have tickets for Saturday, August 27th against Florida, please note that game has been changed from a 3:05 to a 12:20 first pitch. So 12:20 for the first pitch against Florida. Saturday, August 27th. Payoff pitch just missed, and the first two men have reached here in the fourth inning. Astros' best hitter, Morgan Ensberg. He is 1-for-7 against Zambrano. The pitch, lined past Garcia Parra into left. Base is loaded. And Nomar made a great catch to Rob Palmeiro in the second. Just couldn't get to that hot shot. And they're full for Mike Lamb, who hit his first career grand slam off Mark Pryor on May 1st.
Good effort by Nomar, that hooking line drive. He had just moved over a step to his left to bluff Biggio back to second base as that pitch was delivered, and then it was hit back to his right, just a little bit short with his jump.
Lamb getting his first start in the series. He's at first base tonight. Big spot here for Zambrano. Cubs lead 3-0, but the Astros have three on with no outs. One-0 offering, and backhanded by Lee. They get the out at second. Zambrano covering, but the throw eludes him, and unfortunately for the Cubs, it goes into the Astros dugout. So a couple of runs in, and it's 3-2. Cubs obviously going to give up one no matter what. So 3-6 for the out, but the error on Nomar allowing the other runner to score. Lamb does get one RBI.
Now probably an ill-advised throw from Nomar. Obviously after the fact we can say that, but you got Carlos Zambrano on the move over there. It was a slow hit ball to the right side to begin with. Very little chance of turning two on that ball, but Nomar made the throw anyway, and it tailed back to where Zambrano was coming from. He couldn't stop and make the play. The ball goes into the dugout. The second run scores.
So Lamb gets one RBI. The error allowed the second run to score and also let Lamb go to second.
I mean, with that unusual sidearm slinging action that Nomar puts on his throws, it's tough for a first baseman to catch his throws across the infield sometimes, but especially tough for a pitcher on the move.
Popped up, Walker going out, two down. So Palmeiro's gone. And here's Adam Everett. Cubs still lead, however, it's just by a run, 3-2. Another pop-up, foul territory. Does Lee have enough room? Barrett actually reaching over and finds off the top of the dugout, not a play.
Good effort by Michael Barrett. Long way to run after this foul ball. He knows he's getting close to that railing, gets right up against it and tries to reach over. And Lance Berkman right there to make sure Michael doesn't flip over the railing and injure himself. Good sportsmanship right there from Berkman.
And the 1-1. Rolled foul toward the cut dugout. Zambrano with 2-0 in five starts in July. He's 2-1 to start August with a 1.06 earned run average. Zambrano struck out four of the first five hitters he faced tonight. No strikeouts since, but he's 1-2 on Everett, the pitch. Well, there is number five on the night to end the inning. Astros get a pair of runs. We move to the fifth inning, 3-2 Cubs.
More and more people are switching to the trucks and SUVs they really want. GMC.
Going from the Dodge to the Sierra, I love this ride.
I shopped for 6 months. The Yukon had everything I wanted.
I'm so glad I moved up from my Ford into this new GMC.
You can still get the employee discount for everyone on remaining 05 models. Get a Yukon two-wheel drive SLE for just $28,845. See the pros at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana GMC dealers today.
Starts out this cold, it ends up this refreshing. Coors Light.
Good morning, Mr. Farquhar. How are we today? Let's just take a look, shall we?
Huh?
Oh, it's a big gap. Maybe we could drill a hard one right up the middle. We're going inside.
Bow! Yes! It's out of there! It's out of there! Yes! Yes!
Are you fan enough? Nobody does baseball better than Comcast Sportsnet. Catch the Cubs all season long. More games, more news, more passion.
Thank you.
Can't wait for the fair season. Then get your football fix this summer with Comcast Sportsnet Countdown to Kickoff. Our news crew is all over the Bears training camp in Bourbon A to bring you the latest news. Plus, hear from the players and coaches on how they're preparing for the upcoming season. And get up close and personal with your favorite gridiron stars. Don't miss the Countdown to Kickoff every night throughout Bears training camp, only on Comcast Sportsnet.
This telecast of Cubs baseball is brought to you by Felco, Chicagoland's replacement specialist.
3-2 Cubs as we start the fifth inning. A lot of Cubs fans here in Houston. Comes with four hits, the Astros with two. One of those runs for Houston in the fourth inning, unearned. Check swing foul by Barrett. And Michael down in the count, 0-1. He's 0-4-1 tonight. Came in hitting .328 over his last 19 games. Oswalt ready again, 0-2. The glove of Oswalt. Michael hustling, the throw to first. Not in time. So leadoff man is on here in the fifth inning. That one got off the glove of Oswalt. And a good hustle by Michael Barrett.
And hustle is what it was. This time of season for a catcher who's back there on a fairly regular basis. Those legs are starting to get pretty heavy right about this time of the season. Michael Barrett giving it everything he has down that first baseline. Sees that ball ricochet away from Oswalt. And even helps the umpire a little bit.
And Zambrano trying to bunt, pops it up. Still haven't heard an official ruling on the Barrett play. We'll assume it's a hit, but they haven't posted it yet. One out here in the inning.
Ball wasn't hit particularly hard back to the mound, but I don't know if I've ever seen a ball hit back to the mound off a pitcher called anything but a base hit.
So it's Matt Lawton. And Barrett still at first and one out. It is a hit for Barrett.
Well, good, because I already wrote it in my book. I don't want to have to change it. And you have to take into consideration that pitcher, after he releases the ball, is usually standing, you know, 52, 53, 55 feet away from home plate. That ball gets back there in a hurry. Like I said, I don't recall seeing a line drive hit back to the mound off of a pitcher and have it called anything but a base hit.
1-0 to Lawton with Barrett running. And that was not swinging. I don't know if that was a straight steal or not, but Barrett thrown out by Brad Ausmus.
I have to believe that's some kind of missed sign right there. Michael Barrett is not the guy on this roster that would straight steal a base. Takes three or four steps and then a quick peek to his left to see what's going on at home plate. And when he sees that Matt Lawton is not swinging at the pitch, he knows he's in trouble. Once again, the hit and run, the onus is on the hitter. He's got to put that ball in play or foul it off or at least take a swing at that ball and hold that catcher back. The runner at first base is not trying to steal. He's breaking late, making sure the pitcher's delivering the ball home, and the batter has to protect the runner.
On the way. Now 3-2. Matt Lawton acquired from the Pirates on July 31st for Jody Garrett. High bouncer toward first and kicks foul.
Matt Lawton probably hasn't seen a lot of hit and run signs since coming over from the Pirates. Cubs haven't done a lot on the bases over the last month or so. They've been playing it pretty much straight up, letting everybody just swing the bat. So maybe to compound the situation of the new guy on the team, maybe not knowing the signs as well as he should. And then putting a hit and run play on when he hadn't seen one since he's been here. No excuse. I mean, it is the major leagues, and getting signs is a big part of your job. And, of course, we probably should say maybe it's not Matt Lawton's fault, but somebody missed a sign on that hit and run.
So another 3-2 on the way. Sinking liner, center field, caught by Taveras. Well, Barrett with the infield single to start the inning, but it goes for naught. 3-2 Cubs.
Oh, that is gorgeous.
Oh. I am so glad we finally all got together.
Yeah.
But before we get started with dinner, we have a super business opportunity we'd like to share with you. Cleaning products.
Want to get away? Now you can. Fly Southwest Airlines nonstop from Chicago Midway to select cities for just $89 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
No Venetian blinds. That's why Geico.com is so simple. Or is it because you can get help if you need it and get a free rate quote in minutes? 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Simple as that.
Pontiac Grand Prix, built at the highest ranked plant in North and South America. Vibe, the best selling car in its class. Pontiac G6, Strategic Vision's Total Quality Award winner in its first year. And now, get GM employee pricing on almost every 2005 Pontiac left in stock. That means while supplies last, you can get a 2005 Grand Prix starting at $19,143. You pay what we pay, not a cent more.
Time now for the Pontiac Sports Night Update.
Hi, everyone. Carrie Sayers here with you. We'll get you back out to the game in just a minute, but first, an update on the Bears. Training camp is officially over. The Bears packed up their things and left Bourbonnais late this afternoon. Top draft pick Cedric Benson, still a holdout. Much more tonight on Jim Beam Sports Night after Cubs postgame live, but now we'll send it back to Len and Bob in Houston. Guys?
Carrie, thank you very much. Nomar is out of the game. Nathy Perez into play short. Nomar hit a home run in the fourth inning. Of course, he made a catch on a line drive and then went after another one later. Well, you hope the groin hasn't acted up, but some sort of injury to Nomar Garciaparra, and he is out. 3-2 Cubs, bottom five. Brad Ausmus with a one-strike count on him. Ausmus, it's the pitcher Oswalt. Swung on and missed. 1-2. Ausmus walked his first time. How about this note in the Astros game notes? He is 765th on the career hits list with 1,272.
Climbing the ladder.
46th all time among catchers.
Brad Ausmus has had himself a real good career. He's known for his receiving abilities. Was a great thrower earlier in his career. Doesn't throw quite as well now, but they love the way he handles a pitching staff, and the offense is strictly a bonus.
Got him. Called strike three.
We talked about Nomar making the catch on that line drive to his left up the middle of the field. Really had to extend at the very end. Watch how far he has to reach out there. Not sure if that's when he injured it or perhaps on the jump later on the line drive base hit into left field when he mistimed his jump and just missed the ball, but was limping noticeably and had to come out of the ball game.
Stiffness in his lower back. That's the word we've gotten from the Cubs clubhouse. And Oswalt taps one on the ground at Derek Lee, who will shuffle over and touch first. Well, certainly, I'm not a doctor, and we don't claim to be medical experts, but with the groin injury, Bob, you have to think that's going to affect other things.
Well, and even subconsciously, he may be protecting against that groin and putting strain on other body parts, but obviously we hope that's nothing too serious.
So hopefully nothing serious as Jim Henry looks on, Cubs general manager.
Hey, you think a general manager gets to sit in the stands and enjoy a ball game with his family? He's probably getting a call from Mark O'Neill right now, updating him on Nomar's condition.
One on Willie Taveras.
And that's certainly not out of the ordinary when a player leaves a ball game because of an injury. You want to assess it as quickly as possible to see if a roster move is necessary so you can notify the appropriate people down in Iowa. Let them know that you're going to need to reach down there for a replacement. Of course, we're not even speculating that Nomar's injured bad enough to go back on the DL, but that's kind of the protocol that a general manager and a training staff will go through when there's an injury on the field. You have to let the general manager know as soon as you know how serious the injury is so he can make the appropriate phone calls and the arrangements to get a replacement up here if necessary.
Jim sitting with his daughter Lauren. Zambrano gave up two runs, one unearned run in the fourth inning. He has allowed just two hits tonight. This is his first outing against the Astros here in 0-5. Taveras with an awkward half swing. He went far enough. Seventh strikeout for Zambrano. Cubs 3, Astros 2.
Your guide to the all-new Hyundai Sonata. It has more standard safety features than any car in its class, like 6 airbags, electronic stability control, and active front head restraints. Plus, award-winning quality backed by America's best warranty. All for $4,500 less than Accord. the all-new Hyundai Sonata. Starting at just $18,495, it's a Hyundai like you've never seen before. Test drive the fuel-efficient all-new Hyundai Sonata, starting at just $18,495.
Nice.
Very nice.
Do you think they're...
Oh, yeah. They're plastic. And they're spectacular.
Just in time for summer, it's the Coors Light Cooler Box. 18 16-ounce plastic bottles that stay colder longer. Just ice it up, take it out, and enjoy. The Coors Light Cooler Box.
Wow. Close up, they look even bigger.
Since we introduced the Ford Family Plan, hundreds of thousands of Americans have joined in on the savings. Now we're extending the plan for a limited time. Get the same low prices Ford employees pay for America's most popular line of SUVs. Family pricing on Ford Explorer, America's best-selling, most trusted SUV. Now get a Ford Explorer 4x4 for just $24,739. That's over $8,100 in savings on America's most trusted SUV. No hassles, no gimmicks. Visit your local Ford store today.
Flying to the Washington area for business? Fly Southwest, the airline committed to serving Chicago, with these nine convenient nonstops from Chicago Midway to Baltimore, Washington International. And fly Southwest in more comfort than ever for the same low fares you're used to.
You are now free to move about the country.
Hey, come to Wrigley Field on Van Camp and Investments Day, Tuesday, August 23rd. The Cubs will play the Braves at 7:05. Lucky seat winners will take home a special cooler, compliments of Van Kampen Investments. This half inning of Cubs baseball brought to you by Robert Morris College, real college for the real world. And the Cubs lead 3-2. Well, they beat Andy Pettitte last night, trying to beat Roy Oswalt here tonight. Couple of guys in the top five at ERA in the National League. Fouled away by Walker. Mention the home numbers for Oswalt. He has the lowest career ERA of 2.58, the highest winning percentage of 7.68 at home of any active pitcher with at least 65 career starts in home games.
Well, he wanted that last pitch to Todd Walker. Borderline low fastball just below the knees.
Fourth overall in the National League in ERA. Here in 2005. Only 20-game winner in the National League last year. Shoots that one down the right field line, but he pulled it too much. And it's out of play. Still 2-2.
Boy, that'll make a pitcher rethink his plan of attack on a hitter. He was working Walker away, away, away. Todd just getting a piece of each one of them. Tried to sneak a fastball by him in the inside corner, and Walker just snap hooked it foul down that right field line. When you see that, usually you'll see a pitcher go back away again. Todd Walker showing he's extremely quick inside on that heater, so Oswalt will probably try to get him out away.
Ground ball to Biggio. Biggio with a couple of errors in his series, but handled that one cleanly. One out here in the sixth with Derek Lee coming up. Spent some talk about Roger Clemens this week. He's struggled a little bit with some back problems, but he's good to go tomorrow night as Milwaukee comes in. For a four-game series, he'll face Tomo Oka. Clemens will go into that start tomorrow night with a 1.32 earned run average. You know, the National League ERA, the entire league is 4.28. So he's basically been 3 runs better than everybody else.
National League hitting only 186 against Clemens this year.
just having an unparalleled season, or I guess the word of the night would be non-peril, a non-peril year for Roger Clemens. 132. You do think about Bob Gibson, don't you? 1968. And that was not a hitter's era. This is, but Roger Clemens is taking care of business. Rolled off the glove of Biggio. It'll be a hit for Lee. Derek leading the league in hitting coming in tonight. And that's his first hit.
Yeah, all those flashy numbers we talk about for Roger Clemens, and one that is probably just as important as you get one more look at Derek Lee's base hit off the glove of Craig Biggio. For Phil Garner, when Roger Clemens takes the mound after an Astros loss, he's 9-1. Now, Roy Oswalt, when he takes the mound after an Astros loss, he's had 8 starts. He's 2-6. And we talk about the closer being the stopper, but sometimes that guy in the rotation that can stop a losing streak is the real stopper. And Clemens has been that guy for the Astros this year.
Lamb holding the runner Lee at first, and a pitch to Ramirez, to Everett. He'll get it out at second. Biggio to throw to Lamb, and a double play. 6-4-3, the Astros turn it. Bottom 6, 3-2, Cubs with the lead.
Hey, Bacardi guy, Cola.
Oh, hey,
Don't you remember my name?
Sure we do. Anne. Karen.
Aaron. Sarah. Kimberly.
Julie. Mindy. Letitia.
Pearl. Veronica.
Tammy.
Yeah, Veronica, you do remember. You guys look hot.
Yeah.
They get the job done.
Start a new journey. Chart a new course. Go a new way. Discover the new Infinities at the Infiniti Limited Engagement Summer Event. Like the all-new Infiniti M, winner of Car and Driver's 2005 Sports Sedan Comparison Test. See your Infiniti dealer for attractive lease and finance rates. But don't wait too long. Infiniti's limited engagement ends September 6th.
Wait for the bear season, then get your football fix this summer with Comcast Sportsnet Countdown to Kickoff. Our news crew is all over the Bears training camp in Bourbon A to bring you the latest news. Plus, hear from the players and coaches on how they're preparing for the upcoming season, and get up close and personal with your favorite gridiron stars. Don't miss the Countdown to Kickoff every night throughout Bears training camp, only on Comcast Sportsnet. He swings a powerful bat.
Derek Lee crushes one.
Unbelievable. He flashes the leather.
Caught by Lee.
And this year, he's done it all on the north side.
What a night.
What a season.
Triple crown contender Derek Lee continues a year to remember.
He has done it yet again.
Follow him all season long on Comcast Sportsnet. Nobody does baseball better.
You're watching Chevy Baseball Wednesday on Comcast Sportsnet.
Stick around for Cubs postgame live following this one, presented by Joe's Crab Shack. Get highlights of all the action and analysis from Dan Plesac. Don't miss Cubs postgame live immediately following the game right here on Comcast Sportsnet. A strike on Craig Biggio. Last time he led off an inning, a fourth inning, he doubled, and the Astros ended up scoring 2 runs. Make it a one-run game. Still 3-2. And we'd like to welcome all of our viewers watching on RTC Communications in Rochester, Indiana tonight.
Big inning here for Zambrano and the Cubs. Cubs and the Astros have one thing in common offensively. The sixth inning has been the best inning for both teams this season. The Cubs have scored 89 runs in the sixth inning this year. They were held down tonight in the top of the sixth. The Astros have scored 95 runs in the sixth inning, by far their best individual inning.
And on the hands and fouled back our way. Big Z with seven strikeouts already. He has walked two. High fly for the stands down that right field line. Bagwell, the all-time extra base hits leader in Astros history. Craig Biggio with number 900, a double in the fourth inning. Jose Cruz is now the Astros' first base coach.
And Jimmy Wynn, the toy cannon you saw on that list, played his career over at the old Astrodome in the days when the fences were extremely deep. Gotta believe if he was playing in this ballpark, he'd be much higher up on that list.
I was talking with Chris Spire and Greg Maddux about the Astrodome. And there was not a very good hitter's background either. She had deep dimensions. And Spy was saying that not a great place to hit.
No.
For a lot of reasons. Right center field. Patterson over. Burnett's will make the catch in front of Corey, who peeled off. One out.
Well, that looked like a nice job of communication out there between Patterson and Burnett. They both looked away from the fly ball. It seemed like they made eye contact. Burnett indicated somehow to Corey that he was going to make the play. You see him look at each other. Corey then veers behind Burnett, lets him come across and make the play. Boy, communication is so important for outfielders, as we've seen in the past week. Mike Cameron and Carlos Beltran in New York. A terrible collision in right center field.
I think Beltran returned to the lineup for the Mets tonight. Check that out as Berkman fouls it back. And a strike on Berkman. One and two. Side count even. On the bottom of the sixth tonight. Rubber game of this three-game series. Jimmy Wynn watching this one tonight. And called strike three. Well, Berkman has a quick word with Randy Marsh. Strikeout number eight for Zambrano. Two down here in the sixth.
That ball's right there on the outside corner at the knees. One of the few borderline pitches we've seen called the strike on a two-strike count tonight.
Carlos Beltran is back in the Mets lineup. They lead the Pirates 3-1 in the sixth inning at Shea tonight. But the Mets have learned Mike Piazza will miss at least a few games. He has a broken bone in his hand, a hairline fracture, hit by a foul tip last night. Well, I've never heard of this bone. I'm not even going to try to pronounce it. P-I-S-I-F-O-R-N. A little dangerous to even try to pronounce it.
Go ahead, partner.
No. It's a medical term, but we'll just leave it alone.
Small bone in his hand.
Yeah, there you go. A hairline fracture. 2-2 on the way. Yeah, we'll do it again. Hey, earlier this week in Wrigley, the site of the RBI Championship Games, reviving baseball in inner cities. RBI. Cubs put it together. Union League Boys and Girls Club. RBI staff wanted to thank the Cubs for all their support. Zambrano strikes out Morgan Ensberg. And we'll head to the seventh. And the Cubs have the advantage, 3-2.
It's here, Suzuki Smart Summer Savings, where more and more people are discovering Firenza.
Firenza!
Firenza by Suzuki!
Firenza's got it all. Style, function, and America's number one warranty.
And it comes with more room.
And more features than Civic.
Who says you can't have it all?
Suzuki is on a roll with great cars, great deals, and America's number one warranty. So don't miss Suzuki's Smart Summer Savings.
It was the smartest move I ever made.
Firenza!
Get the Firenza for just $11,994 during Suzuki's Smart Summer Savings.
See Wrigley Field like you've never seen it before. Take an official Wrigley Field tour. Visit the Cubs clubhouse, the dugout, the playing field, and more. It's a Cubs fan's dream come true. Call 773-404-CUBS today for ticket information and tour dates.
Shining is giving someone a voice. With Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, you'll have the tools and flexibility to make the smartest decisions for you and your family. Because we believe your health care should stay right where it belongs, in your hands.
Lean on me.
Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, shining through.
Whether you like Jack Daniels mixed, straight, or on the rocks, there's really only one way to drink it. Responsibly.
Chevy's proud to be the number one selling passenger car brand in America. We have 9 cars with at least 30 highway miles per gallon. We've always broken the rules. Now we're rewriting them with the Chevy employee discount for everyone. You pay what we pay, not a cent more. Now get an 05 Chevy Malibu with an MSRP of $19,825 for a Chevy employee discount price of $15,692 after cash back. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today.
The Cubs take on the Marlins Friday, August 26th at 1:20 on Culver's Day at Wrigley Field. Make sure to arrive early and be one of the first 10,000 fans. We'll take home a Cubs hat, compliments of Culver's. And again, the game the following day, the 27th, moved up to 12:20. Originally slated for 3:05. Nathy Perez, first at bat of the night, and a base hit. Now in there for Nomar, left in the fifth inning, stiffness in his lower back. Well, the Cubs really want some insurance here, leading by just one.
It'll be a time for Corey Patterson to attempt a bunt for base hit. Ideally, he puts it down perfectly, beats it out for a base hit, and the Cubs really have some action, but even if they're able to throw him out at first base, it should allow Nafe to advance into scoring position for Jeremy Burnett and Michael Barrett.
Ensberg in on the grass at third. Lamb is holding on the runner at first. Quick throw over there. We mentioned the RBI championship games, and many of the Cubs players were sponsors of various teams. Corey Patterson's team, the Patterson's Primetime Players. You have the G Unit, Glendon Rush. Bernitz's Lumber Yard. Zambrano's two seamers. Barrett's Bears. Walker's Game Winners. Hairston's Generals. Woody's Warriors. Dempster's Dynasty. Lee's Dreammakers. Some good names. Those RBI teams. Inside on Corey. And Ausmus will head out and chat with Oswald.
Oswald was very near balking on that last delivery. Just the slightest of hesitations before delivering that ball home. I haven't seen a lot of balks called this year. That seems to be one of the rules that has gone by the wayside this season. A lot of pitchers really pushing the limit, not giving that discernible stop out there before delivering the ball to home plate in an effort to slow down the running game. Good hit and run count here at 2-1. Pitcher figures to throw a strike right here. He doesn't want to go to 3-1.
Right side. Biggio will get it out at second, and that's it. So a fielder's choice for Patterson.
BJ, with a dangerous decision here, choosing to go to second base. You can see Nafee had to hold up momentarily. That made Biggio's decision for him. Able to wheel around, get the lead runner at second base. And once again, even though the Cubs have not been very adventurous on the base paths, this is one guy at first that can steal a base. I look for Corey to try to get a big jump over there, pick a pitch to run on.
Burnett lines one to right, and it'll drop in front of Palmeiro. Corey had to, of course, wait about halfway between first and second. And Burnett's with his first hit in the series. Two men on.
Well, sometimes you work your way back out of a slump. They say the thing you have to do is get jammed a few times. That shows you're staying on the ball, staying in the strike zone. Keeping that bat in the zone a long time. That time Jeremy jammed a little bit, but muscled it out into right field.
Both runners move up. That's big. Second and third now with only one out. It's a wild pitch on Oswalt, his fourth of the year.
Osmus just reaches across, tries to backhand that ball on the short hop. Not really much of an effort by the catcher to block that pitch. That is huge. Takes the obvious double play out of the equation, forces the Astros to bring the infield in.
But Dusty has talked about this spot as a hitter. He said when he played, he loved seeing that infield come in. This is an ideal spot for a hitter. And a 1-0 count on Barrett. The pitch. 1-1.
When those infielders are drawn in, even with the baseline or even in front of the baseline like they are now, I mean, any ball that's not hit directly at an infielder is probably going to get through. Really limits their range when they come in and play that close to home plate.
Swing and a miss after a slider. Barrett with a high fly to right field toward the corner. Palmeiro will make the catch in fair ground. Runners tag. Patterson scores, and it's 4-2. So Barrett gets the job done with a sac fly. RBI number 51 for Michael.
Barrett does a nice job of battling, gets a pitch up and out over the plate, lofts it high in the air down that right field line, right on the line, called a fair ball by first base umpire Jim Wolf, and Patterson will tag and score easily on that play.
Zambrano with a home run his first time, popped down on a bunt attempt in the fifth inning. Two career home runs here in this ballpark. The other one he hit off Wade Miller on July 25th of 03. He has four career home runs, and two have been hit here at Minute Maid. First Cup pitcher to hit a home run against Houston was at the Astrodome in 85. Steve Engelhoff, Bob Knepper. Rick Sutcliffe once went deep against Jim DeShays, Kerry Wood off Jose Lima. That was in 2000. That was the year Lima set the National League home run record.
Well,
big cut.
Yeah, Lima gave up 48 home runs in 2000. Apparently it wasn't Lima time all the time.
Foul back. The next pitch. Swing and a miss. Cubs done in the seventh, but they do add an insurance run on the Barrett sack fly. It's now 4-2.
As the sweltering days of summer come to pass, the time comes for an event so momentous it can't be missed. The Toyota Time Clearance Event. Now, get up to $2,000 cash on the available all-wheel drive Sienna. Take $700 cash on America's number one selling car, Camry. Or $800 cash on Highlander with a 27 mile per gallon rating. Catch this event now. When it comes to deals like these, everyone wins. That's moving you forward.
Bacardi guy, cola, help! I spilled something on my dress.
I'll splash a club soda to get that out.
Great! Let's dance!
I'm dirty too.
Who's dirty?
They get the job done.
Since we introduced the Ford Family Plan, hundreds of thousands of Americans have joined in on the savings. Now we're extending the plan for a limited time. Get employee pricing on F-Series, America's best-selling trucks, including F-150, the highest-ranked light-duty full-size pickup in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. Now get a built-for tough F-150 for just $15,270. That's over $6,000 in savings on a new F-150. No hassles, no gimmicks. Visit your local Ford store today.
Hi, everyone. Carrie Sayers here with you. Here's what we've got going on later tonight on Jim Beam Sports Night after Cubs postgame live. The Bears sign a new offensive threat and say goodbye to camp in Bourbonnais. Meanwhile, the Eagles say hello again to Terrell Owens. We have T.O.'s first day back covered. And, of course, complete highlights of the Cubs and Sox. Join Chuck Garfine and me for Sports Night after Cubs postgame live.
On Sunday, August 28th, be sure to arrive early for the Ryne Sandberg jersey retirement ceremony. Festivities begin at approximately 12:35 p.m. Additionally, the first 10,000 fans will receive an authentic Hall of Fame cap compliments of Pepsi. Well, Dusty Baker didn't want to call this a must-win. You don't really have to characterize it. Just understand how important it is. And Dusty and the Cubs certainly understand how big it is to beat the team leading the wild card race this late in the season. Cubs 6.5 out. To just play the best game you can and start piling up some wins. One and one on Mike Lamb. Two balls and a strike after Lamb, Palmeiro, and then Everett here in the Astros' seventh. Zambrano's next pitch will be number 90. Here it is. Walker ranging to his left. I mean, you've been in the manager's chair before, and I know people want to know what Dusty has to say. And you know, there are times we have to pull back a little bit and not make these big proclamations. And that's why, as Dan Wheeler gets ready, you never want to say a must win until it's really officially a must win.
Absolutely.
So, you know, hopefully fans don't read too much into that kind of stuff. I mean, you can sit at home and say it's a must win. That's fine. But you know, you just want to tell your guys, go out, play your best game. Don't worry about anything else.
I mean, you know, the reality of it is every day is a must win. I mean, when you look at it, if your approach is that every day is the biggest game of the season and go out there today and give it everything you have to win a ball game, and if you do that all season long and you have talented enough players, chances are you're going to be where you want to be at the end of the season. I think these must-win games and must-win series are more media-created. We're as guilty as anybody of trying to put more emphasis on one game or one series over another, but bottom line is you just have to go out there and win ball games. And because of where the Astros are in the wild card standings or where the Cubs are in the standings, this is a big game for the Cubs, no question about it. But to label it a must-win game, well, that may be a little bit too premature. Certainly would make things a lot easier to win this ball game and move on to Colorado, but if you would happen to lose it, it's not the end of the season.
One hopper to Lee, telling Zambrano, I got it.
You know, and also when you characterize a series or a game as a must win, you know, what is it you expect from your players at that point? I mean, are they going to turn it up a notch? That would indicate they haven't been playing to their fullest in the games leading up to this one. So, you know, as a manager, you just try to prepare your guys every day, give them a sense of urgency every day they go out there to take the field, regardless of who the opponent is.
Were you ever put in a situation where you were asked, is this a must win, and you said no, and then your team won, and after the game you said, we had to get that one?
I probably have, yeah.
We had to win that game.
You know, I think back to spring training. Teams that win a lot of games in spring training, they say, yeah, it's good to win in spring. You know, start establishing good habits, finding ways to win ball games. And teams that lose in spring training say, hey, we're just getting our work in. Doesn't mean anything until the bell rings. Well, you can get out of it whatever you want. But I'm sure I've done that before.
Numbers for Zambrano tonight, nearing 100 pitches.
Well, we said the Cubs needed a big one out of Carlos tonight, and so far he has come through in a big way with very little margin for error.
To center, Patterson backing up. And Zambrano at 99 pitches through seven. He has given up just a couple of runs, one unearned run, two hits, and the Cubs lead 4-2.
We stay another day.
Sure.
Florida. Easy to get to, hard to leave. Go to southwest.com for Southwest Airlines $59 internet specials from Chicago Midway to Florida, including our new nonstop service to Fort Myers, Naples. Travel by November 17th.
You are now free to move about the country.
Things hotter. Cadillac. Breakthrough. The Cadillac employee discount for everyone. You pay what we pay.
Well, let's flash back. We mentioned Gary Gaetti. Of course, Dusty Baker in 98 was a manager of the Giants in that playoff to determine the wild card winner. Gary Gaetti with a home run, giving the Cubs a 2-0 lead. The Cubs would win the game 5-3. And go to the division series and play the Atlanta Braves. Gaetti now the Astros hitting coach.
Called him the Rat earlier. That was one of his many nicknames based upon the fact that pitchers tried to sneak a piece of cheese by the Rat and he'd whack it out of the ballpark.
Dan Wheeler now here in the eighth inning. Roy Oswalt went seven. Eight hits, four runs, all earned. Six strikeouts, no walks, and two home runs. Oswalt threw 106 pitches. Top of the order, Matt Lawton. Strike one.
You
floater in there for a strike. Good breaking ball from Dan Wheeler. Working from the stretch with nobody on base to the belt and now to the plate. Cubs just took 3 of 4 from the Cardinals, trying to take 2 of 3 against the Astros. These are the top two pitching staffs in the National League, the Cardinals and the Astros. Lawton with a fly ball, right center. Palmeiro calling for it. He has it. And some want an explanation as to why the Cubs have played such great baseball against the two best teams in the National League Central, a division leader and the wild card leader, after struggling before that against, you know, Cincinnati and the Mets and the Phillies. I don't know if there is an explanation.
I mean, it would be easy to say that the Cubs have played up to the level of their competition or down to the level of their competition, but I'm not so sure that's the case either. I think in some instances, especially when the Reds came to town, they were just swinging the bats well. They were a hot offensive ball club at that particular time. And sometimes you're going to catch a team when they're really rolling.
And they lost 3 of 4 to Arizona before that 1-5 road trip. I think probably the explanation that makes the most sense is a 500 team does that throughout a year, and the Cubs want to be much better than a 500 team, but right now they're 4 under, and teams with mediocre records tend to be streaky in both directions. Walker, and Biggio can't get it. So Todd 2 for 4 tonight.
Both hits just past a diving Craig Biggio. Really rolls over on that pitch. A lot of topspin on that ground ball causes it to accelerate through one of the fastest infields in the National League.
Strike one on Lee. Well, Derek, 3 home runs from a milestone. He has 197 in his career. Career high 35 this year. You know, Ramos Ramirez tied for the team lead in RBIs with 89. Ramirez with a sac fly in the first inning tonight. Crush.
It hasn't been an issue in this series, but there have been problems with Minute Maid Park in the past when they open the roof later in the ball game. You can see the flags in center field, obviously, with no wind blowing inside the ballpark, hanging straight down. And the roof takes so long to open that they'll start it in the top half of the inning when the visiting team is hitting.
Tavares went back originally and then came in.
And you can clearly see it as the roof starts to open slowly as the visiting team is hitting. The flags start to move around a little bit. Then by the time the home team comes up to hit in the bottom half of the inning, the roof is fully opened and the flags are howling straight out to left center field. I know I argued it a couple of different times coming in here to Houston that I felt it was an unfair advantage to the home team. And the argument was duly noted, but to the best of my knowledge, there is no easy way to remedy that situation. It just takes a while for this roof to open up, and in my eyes and in a lot of managers in the National League over the past couple of years, it creates an unfair advantage for the home team in the bottom half of the inning. Fortunately, we don't have to worry about that tonight.
Walker with his lead at first. And the 0-1 to Ramirez. Ground ball surrounded by Adam Everett. The throw over to Lamb. Inning over. To the last of the eighth, Cubs lead 4-2.
I'll take the red one, please.
Dad.
Treat yourself to the best values of the year at the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event at your Chicago area Lexus dealer.
Really worthwhile.
Animals also possess several.
Burnett's deep to center field. This ball is way back out of here. Jeremy Burnett.
Hello.
With a home run.
Oh yeah.
Are you fan enough? Nobody does baseball better than Comcast Sportsnet. Catch the Cubs all season long. More games, more news, more passion.
Last week, if you just got the scores, you didn't get the whole picture.
The reason why you play this game is because you want to start. If you're planning to be a backup quarterback, then I really don't think you should be playing in the NFL.
I think the main thing is really just get focused on playing baseball and help this team win some games and get the pennant race.
I think people are taking it way too serious. Let's remember at the end of the day, it's about the fans, the people that pay to come get entertained and get away from their 40, 50-hour work week.
Get your game on Comcast Sportsnet.
Time now for the Cadillac Sports Night Update.
Good evening, everyone. Carrie Sayers back in our Comcast Sportsnet studios. The Bears making some moves as they break camp in Bourbonnais today, signing wide receiver and return specialist J.J. Moses to a two-year deal and releasing running back Fred Russell. Moses was the leading kickoff and punt returner last year for the Texans. We'll have more on the Bears tonight on Jim Beam Sports Night after Cubs postgame live. But now we'll send it back to Len and Bob in Houston. Guys?
Thank you, Karen. You could talk about timely hitting, and certainly the Cubs have gotten that the last two nights, but it starts, as always, with the starting pitching.
Everything starts with the starting pitching. If you can send your guy out there to the mound, he keep the opponent's offense in check, keep the runners off base, give your offense an opportunity to get back in there and swing the bats, it sets up the entire ballgame.
Brad Ausmus on the first pitch of the eighth inning with a base hit. Dan Wheeler was in the on-deck circle. Of course, he's not going to bat. Looks like it's going to be Jose Vizcaino, the former Cub, to pinch hit.
Double-barreled activity in that Cubs bullpen. Kerry Wood, Will Oman both started throwing as Carlos Zambrano went out to take the mound to start this bottom half of the eighth inning. Carlos right at the 100-pitch mark right now. Certainly doesn't appear to be running out of gas, but you don't want to leave anything to chance in a ball game as important as this one.
Well, we mentioned Kerry Wood last night going just one inning because the Cubs wanted to have him available tonight. Ausmus at first, Vizcaino representing the tying run at the plate. And the first pitch is fouled away, strike one. Vizcaino, switch hitter. Eighth among active switch hitters with 1,403 career hits. 66 career pinch hits for Vizcaino.
See, Aramis Ramirez drawn in at third base, guarding against a bunt. I don't recall the last time I saw Jose Vizcaino bunt, especially not after he had a strike, now two strikes in the count. And, of course, with two strikes, Aramis will back up behind the baseline. I think that's one of those things that sometimes teams just do out of habit. There was a time in his career that Jose Vizcaino was a threat to bunt and was a threat to steal a base. Not anymore.
One and two offering outside. Over 100 pitches for the first time at three starts. Here he comes again, out of the mitt of Michael Barrett, but Osmus holding it first. 3-2.
Well, rattles around in Michael's glove. Looked like a slider that just never really took the break. He was trying to push it back toward that outside corner, but the ball wasn't cooperating.
The kick and the pitch, he struck him out. Zambrano now with 10 punch outs.
Oh, that's a big out right there. Blew that ball right by Vizcaino. He looks back. That Michael Barrett just swung right over the top of that sinker.
Third time this year, Zambrano's been in double digits in strikeouts. His career high is 12. He has 10 tonight. Bunted. It's a beauty by Taveras. Zambrano's throw in time. Great play by Zambrano. He knew he didn't have any time at all. Got it to lead very quickly, and they just got Taveras.
Well, that's an amazing play by Carlos. I didn't think he had any chance to get Taveras. Throws off the wrong foot, falling away from the bag at first, and somehow gets enough on this throw to get the speedy Taveras at first base. Wow. Boy, that is a huge play in a two-run ball game. Taveras is a guy that can score from first base on an extra base hit. Keeping that guy off the base is huge.
So Auspice now at second, two outs in the inning, and it's Craig Biggio, 1-for-3 on the night. Eighth inning, Cubs lead 4-2. Burnett's coming over toward right center. Zambrano already halfway to the dugout. He's pumped up. Here comes the ninth. Cubs lead by two.
We spend our whole day dreaming about what an ATM could be, what it should be. We're working on cash deposits at our ATMs, where you won't even have to use an envelope. You put the cash in, our ATM quickly scans, counts the cash, and totals it for you. I'm Dean Kirby. I'm a banker, and I'm proud to be part of Bank of America. Bank of America has more ATMs around the country than any other bank, over 16,000 of them, and we never stop thinking about how to make them better. We've already carved at least 6 seconds to have the basic transaction. Doesn't sound like a lot unless you think of yourself in a van full of kids like I do. We're also working on transfers and payments at our ATMs. Watch. From checking, take $60 and pay towards your credit card. Or from checking, move $100 into your savings account. We're working on that. Imagine this, depositing checks. Now you see it on the screen, and we print that image on your receipt. At Bank of America, we want each of our ATMs to be a mini Bank of America. A mini bank as good as any big bank we've built.
Bank of America. Higher standards.
Chevy's proud to be the number one selling passenger car brand in America. We have 9 cars with at least 30 highway miles per gallon. We've always broken the rules. Now we're rewriting them with the Chevy employee discount for everyone. You pay what we pay, not a cent more. Now get an 05 Cobalt Coupe with an MSRP of $14,190 for a Chevy employee discount price of $12,471. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today. For a good, good
Hey Cubs fans, looking for a new way to get to Wrigley Field? Try riding your bike. There are several bike racks surrounding the ballpark, or drop off your bike free of charge at our bike check service located at the corner of Clark and Waveland. For more information, visit www.cubs.com.
Try Arby's new bacon, beef, and cheddar. Juicy roast beef, thick cut pepper bacon, and melted cheddar on a toasted onion bun. It'll have you saying, I'm thinking Arby's.
Get ready for an exciting Cubs finish. Brought to you by New Finish Car Polish and the number one rated scratch remover, Scratch Doctor.
now, the Danley's Garage World upcoming schedule. Off day tomorrow, first off day after 16 games in 16 days, and then a three-game several, the Rockies at Coors. Note the start time Friday, 4 o'clock Central here on Comcast Sportsnet. And then our next CSN broadcast will be Monday night back home against the Atlanta Braves. Jose Vizcaino stays in and plays second for Biggio. And the only lefty in the Astros bullpen, Mike Gallo, now on the mound facing Nathy Perez, who will bat right-handed. Cubs are up 4-2. We're in the ninth inning. Bounce to Morgan Ensberg, one out. Florida shut out San Diego tonight, 6-0. Dontrell Willis with his 16th win. He threw a five-hit complete game shutout. They went 1-for-3 with two RBIs and a run scored, and the game took 1 hour and 55 minutes. Carlos Zambrano has gone 8 innings tonight, has allowed 2 runs, just 1 earned run, and a mere 3 hits, and he has hit a home run. Busted bat. Bouncer to Lamb, and that's the second out.
Gallo, the only lefty in the bullpen, as you mentioned, for the Astros. Very similar to former Cub Mike Remlinger. Before tonight's outings, left-handers were hitting 304 against Gallo. Right-handers hitting only 154.
So the Marlins right now, two out, back of Houston. Philadelphia leading Washington 4-3 in the eighth inning. Nationals a half game back. The Phillies are a game out. Mets leading the Pirates 5-1 in the seventh. The Mets 3.5 out. And then you have the Cubs and Brewers 6.5 back. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2 on Burnett's. So the Padres with a loss, leading the West, but back under 500, 59 and 60. They started the night 4 up on Arizona. Diamondbacks trailing at St. Louis 3-0, fourth inning. Cardinals batting, that's foul. Sliding out to the outside part of the plate. And a little tapper will be handled by Gallo. He underhands to Lamb, and the Cubs go down 1-2-3. Zambrano's going to head back out. Look for his second complete game of the year. It's 4-2.
Since we introduced the Ford Family Plan, hundreds of thousands of Americans have joined in on the savings. Now we're extending the plan for a limited time. Get employee pricing on F-Series, America's best-selling trucks, including F-150, the highest-ranked light-duty full-size pickup in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. Now get a built Ford Tough F-150 for just $15,270. That's over $6,000 in savings on a new F-150. No hassles, no gimmicks. Visit your local Ford store today.
Okay, thank you.
I'm new here in front of Bank of America.
The largest network of ATMs and banks in the country. Only from Bank of America. Higher standards.
I can't wait for a minute more. I can't wait.
Get the bottom line now during Nissan's model year-end clearance. The bottom line on America's most exciting full line, including Nissan Xterra, Titan, and Z. Plus a $199 a month lease for 24 months on the stylish and powerful Nissan Altima. See your Nissan dealer now. Clearance time happens once a year. And that's the bottom line.
Get complete sports coverage every night on Jim Beam Sports Night. Coming up tonight after Cubs postgame live, the Bears break camp. Terrell Owens returns to Philly. Join Kerry and Chuck for Jim Beam Sports Night tonight after Cubs postgame live, only on Comcast Sportsnet. Cubs trying to keep that train right where it is. Zambrano has one complete game this year. It was against the Phillies on May 8th at Wrigley, a 2-1 win. And it faces Lance Berkman to start. The bottom of the ninth. And the first pitch of the inning trails outside. Zambrano has five career complete games. One bouncer, Perez to Lee, two outs to go. Zambrano's low hit complete game in his career, a two hitter against the Rockies on May 7th of last year. Right now working on a three hitter. ERA starting this inning 3.07, started the night at 3.17.
On run that the Cubs were able to add in the top half of the seventh inning. So big right now, giving him a two-run lead. If this was a one-run ball game, you're one bad pitch away from a tie game. Carlos can still be aggressive with nobody on base, pounding that strike zone, even to a home run hitter like Morgan Ensberg.
And just in case, Ryan Dempster in the bullpen. He's ready to go. He started throwing late in the top of the ninth. 2-2 in the dirt. Pat Ryan just paused to watch the action, so he's ready if needed. Two pitch, just missed. Will be it for the starter. Boy, Carlos wanted that pitch.
Well, we've seen pitches further off the plate than this called strikes in this series, but just a little bit off right there.
So after 116 pitches, Zambrano done for the night. Todd Hollinsworth is going to come in. Jeremy Bernich made the final out at the top of the ninth. So he's out of the game. Hollinsworth will play right. And we're going to see the closer, Ryan Dempster. Four call to the pen. Dempster will come on, try to preserve a 4-2 lead.
We stay another day.
Sure.
Florida. Easy to get to,
hard to leave.
Go to Southwest.com for Southwest Airlines $59 internet specials from Chicago Midway to Florida, including our new nonstop service to Fort Myers, Naples. Travel by November 17th.
You are now free to move about the country.
It's a wonderful world. I'm just walking on air. Talk of heaven on earth. I've got more than my share. Haven't got a care.
Rico Dependability moves your ideas forward.
It's a wonderful
changes
world.
Too.
Loving wonderful.
Chevy's proud to have the best-selling full-size SUVs 5 years in a row. Like Tahoe with best-in-class fuel economy. We've always broken the rules. Now we're rewriting them. With the Chevy employee discount for everyone. You pay what we pay, not a cent more. Now get an 05 Chevy Trailblazer LS two-wheel drive with an MSRP of $27,150 for a Chevy employee discount price of $21,417 after cash back. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today.
Carlos Zambrano with just a magnificent performance tonight. Not only they go 8 1/3 and allow just 3 hits, couple of runs, 1 unearned run, but he hit a home run to help his own cause. The Cubs right now with a 4-2 lead. Todd Hollinsworth into play right, and Ryan Dempster will try to pick up his 18th save and second in 2 nights.
Not only did Carlos do all the things you just mentioned, but a great defensive play on Willie Taveras, keeping a speedy runner off base who represented the tying run at the time before retiring Craig Biggio to end that eighth inning. That was a big out at the time.
Throws back in. And on the ground, Walker will get it out. Perez. I believe everybody's safe. Everybody's safe. First and second. Dusty coming out. Ryan Dempster wondering what's going on. I guess Nathan was not on the base. And we're going to get a pinch runner. Looks like Eric Rutledge is going to come in and run for Mike Lamb. What's going on here? Dusty wants to know.
I think it all started with that backhanded flip from Todd Walker. Came out of his hand a little bit like a changeup. That brought Napi too far across the bag at second. That's my guess, is that perhaps Napi just wasn't on the bag out there at second base. What happened to the old neighborhood play?
Well, it's an error on Napi. With a second error, first and second. We're thinking possibly game-ending double play. Instead, two men on for Orlando Palmeiro. Here's the pitch. He hits it on the ground. Derek will fire to Perez. That is an out. Dempster cannot handle it. Boy, Ryan almost caught it for the final out. Two down. First and third.
Nice play by Derek to initiate this attempted double play. Napi makes sure to stay on the base that time. Another dangerous relay throw to a pitcher covering first base. It looked like Ryan had it in the very end of his glove, but as he tried to drag that right foot across the bag, the ball just rolled out of his glove. Gonna have to do it one more time. He's able to hang on right there. If you see, his foot was off the bag. Yeah, a lot of things went wrong. Fortunately, the ball stayed right there, and the runner had to hold at third base.
Chris Burke, another pinch runner. And it's Adam Everett. Still 4-2. Well, Ryan Dempster came on, got a couple of ground balls. Cubs only able to get one out with him in the game thus far. And a quick throw to first, and Burke back.
Now the Cubs defensively in the outfield have backed up an extra step. Yeah, with the speed of Burke at first base, a double could possibly score the run from first to tie the game, so everybody's backed up a couple of steps.
Yeah, Ensberg's run doesn't matter at third. Cubs' only concern right now, well, really two concerns, obviously the hitter Everett, but that guy at first base. Two outs here in the ninth. The kick and the pitch. 3-0. Ausmus on deck. And the runner moving from first, and Everett swinging away. So he got the green light on a 3-0 pitch.
Wow, I like that play as a base runner. So many teams just completely disregard the base runners on a 3-0 count. Everything kind of stops. Okay, throw a strike and then we'll go back to work. Well, you can take advantage of that a lot of times. And Burke was on the move on the 3-0 pitch.
Again, 3-1, and they're loaded. And Ausmus the hitter. Nobody up in the Cubs bullpen. It's up to Ryan Dempster at this point. Single could tie it. Here's the pitch. Fouled away. Fans on their feet here, just under 30,000. 29,978. Well, the Cubs have been oh so close to getting out of this inning. Turn a double play as Mike Lamb hit a ball on the ground. And that was to second, but Mapy was not on second as he tried to turn the double play. The throw to first was late. And then Palmeiro hit into a fielder's choice. Swing and a miss. 1-2.
Boy, Chris Berkeley showed you the picture right there before the pitch by Ryan Dempster, getting a huge lead at second base. You're kind of caught in between as a defender. You want to try to shorten that lead up as much as you can and give your outfielders a chance to throw him out on a base hit, but you don't want to evacuate your position and leave a hole in the infield. But Burke is getting a tremendous jump out there at second base.
A 1-2 pitch. Going outside. Dempster's going with that slider here. Bounces it foul. A lot of drama here in the rubber game tonight. Leister again. This should do it. Nafe over to Lee, and the Cubs have won the series. They take 2 of 3 against the Astros. Dempster gets the save. Zambrano with the win. And after losing to Wandy Rodriguez in game one, the Cubs come back and beat Andy Pettit last night, and they defeat Roy Oswalt tonight.
Nothing comes easy. A rough ninth inning here. Astros had the bases loaded without the benefit of a base hit. Zambrano picks up the victory. Outstanding. Carlos getting the 10 victories the day after Greg Maddux gets his 10th.
Ends up being a three hitter. Well, let's check out our Hyundai player of the game. It's Carlos Zambrano. How about the home run? Carlos with his first home run of the year, his sixth.